The opposition United Workers Party says the current social and economic status of the country and the outside world must be taken into consideration in any decision to implement value-added tax. The party is therefore questioning the appropriateness of the September 1st deadline.
Listening to the throne speech a few moments ago, from the very onset, the Governor General has given an indication that certainly things are not looking good. Locally, regionally, and internationally. And if this is going to be the backdrop against which VAT is going to be introduced, then there's need for review as to the timing and the appropriateness and relevance of it at this time.
The Solution Chamber of Commerce, for its part, had recently indicated that the business community was not ready for the VAT. According to the private sector body, it was unaware of the list of taxable goods, but a leaked budget document obtained by us appears to contain just such a list. Commenting on that aspect, Mr. King said it is important that there be a smooth transition as far as the implementation is concerned.
One that is seamless and one that doesn't hinder the ability to deliver to their consumers. At the same time, consumers also must be comfortable that the transition period is appropriate for being given this new system of taxation. For sure, the introduction of VAT will call for new systems, the infrastructure both on the government side and the private sector side would have to be augmented to ensure that it is efficient and to ensure that the services are properly delivered.
Just recently, the government had been criticized for setting the date for implementation of VAT before putting the necessary mechanisms in place. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.